passion, 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 passion. Give me somebody to stress out real quick, passion. Tell me what they did. You don't even have to tell me their name. Tell me what they did and let me stress them out. Come on, Pete, let's go. Born as Connecticut. Okay, Connecticut. Thank you, Shelly. Yes, indeed. Welcome to the Let Me Stress You Out. Connecticut is it, Connecticut ain't bad. Some parts is cool. Lying about cancer. Ooh, wow. Is it a woman or a man? Pretty passionate. Somebody lied about having cancer. That gotta be a miserable, stanky, ooh, passion. Man or woman, passion? Come on, it gotta be a woman. I knew it. I knew it was a woman. Who play like that? Who play like that? Don't nobody play like that but a bad built, deep freezer body, going to hell, stanky bitch. Nobody plays like that. That is so not funny. And that's not funny, and I'm a really go with this one because, ladies and gentlemen who don't know, my VP of entertainment, Michelle Nelson, who's on here right now, she is a cancer survivor. She didn't had it, got through it, lost the kink, went through the chemo, got through, and she on her feet now, and she is my vice president of Boogie B Entertainment, and she keeps shit going in here. Thank you, Miss Michelle. And for you, just we appreciate you. But this woman who is lying about cancer, you don't even gotta tell me what she look like, Passion. I know what she look like. I know what a chick who would lie about having cancer look like. She looks uncomfortable. She's not happy with herself. Cause you can't be happy with yourself if you gonna tell people that you got cancer to get sympathy. What you need sympathy for? Thank you, Passion, and your people. Everybody got somebody that passed away from cancer, and she playing like that. A chocolate deep freezer body bitch. Just looking for, that is a damn shame. She looking for sympathy, Passion. That is a damn shame. So, cancer faker, come here. Let me stress you out right fast. Because you got some goddamn nerve trying to get some sympathy. You would get some more sympathy if you lost some of that weight. I'm going to tell you what the problem is. You're not happy with yourself. If you get your hair, get your nice lace front. Go pay a good dollar for it. And you get something that looks believable on your head. And you'll feel better about yourself. Go to the dermatologist and let them pop some of the pimples on your back. And then you will feel better about yourself. You don't need to claim a terminal illness to get sympathy. You trying to act like you've been in a hospital when you built like a hospital. We know you ain't been no damn hospital. We know you ain't got no cancer. You still too big to say you got cancer. So we knew you was lying. You ought to be ashamed of your fat, funky, cheesy ass self. Why would you play like that? Why you gonna say you got cancer and you don't? You ought to be ashamed of yourself. Slick Woods, it was all on the Shade Room. I missed that one. I don't know who Slick Woods is. Damn, let me look up Slick Woods real quick. Hold on, Passion. Let me get some more information on this shit real quick. Because I need to see what this shit... If this shit true, I'ma still go ham. I got a lot more left in me. I'm just on the tip of this iceberg, baby. It's about to... Thank y'all for coming to the Let Me Stress You Out show. Oh, Slick Woods. She do look like she got cancer, though. She don't? I seen this girl before. I did see her before. She's not big. Let me tell y'all this. She do kind of look like she got cancer. But she was always built like that because she's supposed to be like a model. And she just had a gap in her teeth and she bald head. Her head looked like a Her head looked like a kiwi. You know what a kiwi look like? She got a little kiwi head. It's a little fuzz on it. And she lied. And she lied. Yeah, she do get drunk a lot too. She a skinny drunkard. And with a kiwi head. And she damn sure did fake like she got. They say it on him. Yeah, yeah. That's a damn shame. You ought to be ashamed of your... You ought to be ashamed of yourself. You ought to be ashamed of your selfie stick body having ass. You ought to be ashamed. Why would you say that you got cancer, Slick? That's a damn shame. You should really get cancer because you playing like that. Since you're not, come here, let me stress you out right fast, Slick Woods. Because they need to call you Unslick Woods. Because everybody knew you didn't have shit. You was walking around here drinking like a fish. Ain't nobody got cancer drinking like that. Your ass was getting drunk as hell. You was drinking out of bottles that we don't regularly see. You was drinking bullshit. You was drinking everything. You was drinking all types of varieties of whiskey. Ain't nobody got no cancer drinking that much damn whiskey. You would have been dead if you had been drinking like that. Your ass wasn't. Ain't nothing was wrong with your kiwi head ass. Ain't wasn't nothing wrong with you. And you didn't look extra. You was already extra skinny. So hey, we don't know. We never know was you really sick or not, because you was always built like a mini blind string. You was always small. You was always built like a headphone jack. You know the jack that you plug into the phone is straight up and down. You was always skinny as hell. And listen, it was no way of knowing if you really had it or not, but we saw how your behavior was and we knew that you didn't have it. Strawberry Hill drinking ass, Thunderbird drinking ass, Mad Dog 2020 drinking ass, Slitz Malt Liquor Bull drinking ass, Coke 45 drinking ass, Old English Malt Liquor drinking ass. You drinking Wild Irish Rose. You drinking Wild Turkey Rose. You is a drinking ass, slim ass, blade of grass body having bro. And you ought to be ashamed of yourself lying and acting like you got cancer and them people that caught you. You ought to be ashamed, Slick. Thank y'all for coming through. I'm tongue tied. Hold on. Thank y'all for coming to the Let Me Stress You Out show, man. Every day I'll be right here at 5 p.m. Central Standard Time and 3 p.m. on the West Coast, 6 p.m. on the East Coast. So y'all make sure y'all come here and y'all throw out somebody who did something to you or somebody who did something wrong and it's dead wrong or they did. I don't care if it was back in when you was in high school. I don't care if it was when you was in college and you 45 now. If they did something to you, if you feel it, I want to feel it. And let me stress them out. I can't. If I don't feel it, I can't do it. I'm going to just tell you that. So you got to give me something I can feel. We're going to do this every day for an hour. So we got 45 more minutes. Let's go. In the meantime, in between time, I'm going to tell y'all stories in between these stress outs too, man. So y'all just hang in. And then somebody give me a good let me stress you out moment. Then I will stress out whoever they... Oh, your boyfriend... your boyfriend the legend. That nigga was up early in the morning. He was looking like the nigga who was having sex with Tyrese's mama and baby boy. That nigga was in the kitchen with his drawers on, sweating, with a lit blunt, having a good time in that bitch. Loud. She tried to stop him. She was like, "What? Why is you so loud?" That nigga said, "Cause it's lit in this bitch." And he was in there by himself with a blunt in his mouth, listening to some Bluetooth music online in his drawers, having a great gangster time. She could not shut that nigga up, boy. That nigga was in his own zone. Leave that man alone and let him be great. Let that nigga be late, Westside. Be great, G. Be great, nigga. That shit was legendary, nigga. Y'all should have recorded that and put that on TikTok. That nigga was unbothered by her sheer annoyance. Because she was totally annoyed. Because she was all live talking about some good shit. My girl Passion was on there talking about what happened and who was hating. And she was going with the nigga from Love and Hip Hop. They going back and forth laughing and shit. It's hilarious. And she zoomed the camera to this nigga. This nigga in the back. With the music on 10. He got the shit on 10. He got it all the way to the max that the music could go. And that nigga's on live in the zone. You understand me? You try to check that nigga, he gives zero fucks. That nigga that act like you was having a good time too. He didn't give a fuck that you were trying to talk about nothing. Let that nigga be legendary, man. That nigga is a goat over there in that house with you, Passion. That nigga was early in the morning, nigga. It's motherfucking, it's 10:30 a.m. This nigga is up and popping. This nigga got a chain on, a hat on, and his drawers. And that nigga in the kitchen smoking that weed, nigga. And he smoking, nigga, and having a great time. Nigga rapping like he in a concert. I was like, woo, this nigga's going ham. I wanted her to keep talking, but leave the camera on him. Just let me listen to you and let me watch what he about to do. That shit was a fucking movie, man. I love that nigga, man. I ain't met him yet, but I love that nigga, Passion. Passion, you pick good niggas anyway, because you a good chick. Bright and early smoking that gas. Nigga woke up, nigga brushed his teeth and lit a blunt. That nigga said, let me light this blunt. Let me go fix me something to eat, nigga, and let me vibe out, nigga. I don't give a fuck who in the house. Let me turn the Bluetooth speaker all the way to the max. Let it go. He don't know how much I allowed it go, but it's going all the way up. That nigga set that damn kitchen off. That nigga set that kitchen off. Hey, bro, that shit was so funny, man. I couldn't stop laughing. I laughed about that shit the whole rest of the day that day. I said, man, I need to live my life like that, nigga. I need to wake up turned up. That nigga wake up turned and nigga getting himself hyped up, nigga. This shit is crazy. Welcome, y'all. Thank y'all for coming to the Let Me Stress You Out show. I'm going to be here every day at this same time, at this same hour. I'm going to do 1 hour. When this live run out, that's the end of the show. That's what it's going to be every day. 5 days a week. We ain't fuck with no weekends. Hit that Cash App. Y'all ain't got shit to do, man. Hit that Cash App. Dolly, what up? Love, what up? Yeah. What's up, Dolly D? What's up, love? Welcome, welcome, welcome to the Let Me Stress You Out show. I appreciate y'all for coming through. I appreciate y'all coming through and hanging out with me, and we gonna do this every day. Gotta live life, G. We gotta live life. Let Me Stress You Out show, man. Y'all give me somebody to stress out. What they did to you? What they said to you? How did they abuse you in any type of way? Let me stress them out for you. If they stressing you out, let me stress them out. And you'll feel better about the whole situation. You'll feel better about yourself and others. Once I get this off your chest. Let me get this off your chest. Is somebody who you just want to tell them the A to the Z of what they doing wrong? If you want to tell them the A to the Z, let me, come here. Let me stress you out. Come here. Come here, cuz. Come here, co-worker. Come here. Come here, sis. Come here, auntie. Come here, best friend. Let me stress you out. You fucking up. Yo, them women ought to be ashamed of themselves. Hey, that's what we just got to go through, though, Westside TG. That's just a part of it. That ain't, hey, that's a part of the game. The women going to pass gas on you. They definitely going to do that. That's automatic. T-Mobile story. Oh, yeah, the T-Mobile story yesterday, yes. I will tell stories in the middle of this live, too. So when y'all think of somebody y'all want to type in to get stressed out, just put them in there and put kind of a brief description what happened. I'll try to read it and I'll try to stress them out. Other than that, I'm going to just keep talking my shit until I get somebody. I know he talking about you, your little nasty ass Passion with that big old booty. You know you can't be fighting trying to sneak nothing out with that big old booty. You can't sneak nothing out of that ass. You can't sneak nothing out of that booty. That booty is like a damn It's like a sofa cushion. It's like a throw pillow booty. It's one of them booties that when you pass gas, it make a clap sound because that booty cheek so big. That bitch come out like tap, tap. You be like, who? He be sleep, and that shit'll wake him up out of his sleep, Passion. I know it, dude. And you only act like you ain't heard it. You just gonna lay there and chill like ain't shit happened. You know something happened. You know you heard that big pop up in there with all that booty. And you probably sleep naked, too. If I know you like I think I know you, Passion, you sleep naked. You definitely don't want to be passing gas with your naked ass. Put some of them big drawers on you got. Put them big drawers you got, Passion. You got some of them big drawers because you got a lot of booty. When you got a big booty, you can't have all thongs. You have to have a couple of pairs of shorts that covers your whole butt. All that extra hanging out shit, your booty too big for that. Put that shit away. Not that shit you wear out to the club, the short shorts. No, I'm talking about you got to wear something like some big popcorn bag underwear sometimes, especially when you sleep. Look at her, I knew she slept naked, G. With that big stinky booty out, man, put that booty up. Put that big juicy booty up. Don't nobody, when you sleep, cover your booty up. We don't want no naked passing gas. That is terrible. Women, y'all gotta stop doing that. Control y'all gas. Go to the bathroom. If you can't hold, go to the bathroom. If you use the bathroom more often, you wouldn't be holding all that gas up in your stomach when you sleep. Go to the bathroom. Stop trying to hold it. Start eating some more salads or something. Go to the bathroom. Get that out in the morning and at night. Then when you come to bed, you ain't even worried about no. You can sleep comfortably without no bubble in your stomach. And you try to sneak and fall asleep on the sleep. You ain't even all the way asleep. You in that beginning sleep where you know what you're doing. You can still hear the TV on. You can still hear him playing the game. Or you can still hear him watching Netflix. But you fake asleep, and you butt naked, and your booty half hot, so you got one leg hanging from up under the cover. So you half hot, you got one booty cheek hanging out, and then you tuck your booty in, then you want to curl your butt toward him like you're cold. You want to curl your butt up, and then you want to pass gas and act like you're snoring still. You heard that shit. I know you heard yourself pass gas because you stopped snoring when you did it. Huh? Huh, Passion? You stopped snoring when you did it. I know you did. If you a woman, shit, you gotta be a lady like that. Shit sound like, yeah, it sound like lightning striking. You like, what the hell was that? You thought something fell off the bed at first when you heard it. You was like, shit, did the remote drop? What the fuck was that? Passion, put some. You a woman now. Y'all got to use the bathroom now. You can't hold your stomach in all night then and hold it in all day and then try to and sit on it all night too. You can't do that because when you sleep, your body going to take over. If you really got to use it, when you have sleep, that is going to come out now. You got to take your butt and use the bathroom and take your shower before you go to sleep. Thank you, Burpee, for coming in. This is my buddy Burpee in the building. Come on in. Welcome to the Let Me Stress You Out show, man. I appreciate y'all stopping through, man. I'm going to be here every day for 1 hour, 5 p.m. Central Standard Time, 3 p.m. on the West Coast, right here on IG Live. You tell me who to stress out, and I will stress them out for you live right here. And they got to be stressing you out personally, not like somebody you never met. Or somebody that you just see on TV doing something, you know. Make it more personal. Who in your life? What somebody did something to you specifically? And you hate what they did, and you just wish somebody would tell their ass what to do and how to get their shit together. Come here. Let me stress you out right fast. Cousin, auntie, uncle, grandmama even. Anybody can get it. If they did you wrong, let me know about it. Let me stress them out. That's how we're going to do it. Every day, live at the Let Me Stress You Out show, bring me your burdens. Come on, Hazel, what's up? What your black-ass brother did? Come on, tell me what it is. Kind of be a little as specific as you can in a little quick comment. Mr. Thomas, what up? Real Zoe World, what's happening? What's up, bro? Welcome to the Let Me Stress You Out show, man. Tell me who did something to you. Who did it? Who did it? They did what to you? Oh, tell them, come in, let me stress them out right fast. Just tell them for me, and then tell me what they did. Eat and leave. Ooh, I hate to eat and leave. Ooh, I can't stand a big eat and leave, bitch. I can't stand to eat and leave. You just can't. We still on, my bad, y'all. I'm getting damn messages on shit. I can't see your message. I'm on here with you. I can't see your message. Burpee, you ever had somebody did that eat and leave? And you know it's always a big nigga, a big sleepy, snoring, always hungry ass nigga, sleep apnea nigga. It's one of them niggas, the nigga who his shoulders and neck is almost one unit. He used to play on the offensive line in high school, Burpee. He was one of them niggas. And now that nigga got them big ass calves, little legs, and a nothing but upper body. He a big stuffed in nigga. He built like a portobello mushroom. You know what a portobello look like. That nigga just round at the top, and he got a little stem coming from him where his legs at. That little short sandal wearing nigga that be coming to your house talking about, damn, y'all ain't cooked. Like, damn, nigga, you just got here. Did you not eat? Oh, I did eat. I ate some Jack in the Box on the way here. Well, why the fuck is you asking me about what's in the kitchen? Take your Michelin man body having ass back to your house and eat. Damn, y'all ain't got nothing to drink. Y'all ain't got no sodas or no beers or nothing. Damn, nigga, drink some water. That's why your damn eyes so red. That's why your toenails about to fall off, because you always drinking beers and sodas. Your damn toenails is black in your feet, and you look like you got sugar diabetes. Sugar diabetes had a face, it would be you. You stop all that eating. Don't come over here mentioning food every time you're over here. Talking about your old lady ain't cooked. No, she ain't cooked. Not for you. You ate up all them damn turkey wings last time she cooked. Hell no. Don't ask me about no food. Yo, little freeloading ass. What we gonna call him? We gonna call him, he looked like a nigga named, what's his name? It's going good, Paige. Thank you for coming through to the Let Me Stress You Out show. I appreciate it. Gotta leave when their parents call. I don't know if that's a bad thing or not. I don't think she deserved to get stressed out for that now. Skip, what up? Give me a good one, man. Shit. Give me a good one. What we gonna call a nigga who be coming to your house always hungry? Hungry man. And she in her 30s. Oh, you're too young. Bitch, you still get stamps. You get stamps. You big. All big girls get stamps. Come on now, shit. Especially when they always hungry. You know she done found a way to get some food stamps. She ain't even really eligible for food stamps. She done manipulated the system and she got $365 worth of food stamps a month. Plus she got two kids. Ooh, that's a good one. Let me see. Come over to watch Michael Jordan. She smoke weed, take a nap, and then leave. Oh my gosh. Hog jaw. Hog jaw. Come here. Let me stress you out right fast. Cause your big greedy ass. Your big neck ass need to stop. Your ham hock neck ass need to stop coming over here looking for a snack and to smoke up some weed and get full and eat and leave and sleepy. And then you fall asleep while we watching TV and you get the snoring loud. You snoring like a goddamn 18 wheeler starting up. It sound like, it sound like an old box Chevy. When it started, and all the smoke be coming out the tailpipe, you sound horrible. You need to go to the doctor and get some breathe right strips. You need to get something to clear that congestion up in you. Clear that congestion up in your goddamn throat if you're gonna be taking naps at people's house, man. You came over here, you ain't saying shit to nobody. You was coming. You just show up talking about what y'all got to eat. Well, we got to eat. Hey, you just ate. You still smell like a rally burger. You still smell like a Big Buford. You smell like a double champ burger. You smell like a Whataburger. You smell like a number 3 at Jack in the Box. You smell like onion rings. You smell like a sweet tea. You come in this bitch smelling like a Subway sandwich with a meatball sub. You smell like a meatball sub when you came here talking about you hungry. How you gonna be hungry? And you built like a smoked turkey. How the hell you come in here hungry? Built like a smoked turkey. This girl homeless. She trying to take a nap over here. Y'all stretch out, sleep. She sleep. She ain't going nowhere. Y'all wake up like So what time your babysitter need to go on home? Oh, she good. Well, bitch, you good too. Go ahead on up out of here. Yeah, she gotta smell like something with food in it. Westside TG. She gotta smell like something with food. What got food in it? She smell like a street hot dog stand with all them onions on it. When them hot dogs be red, and they have all them onions smoking up the whole neighborhood. Ooh, that street hot dog. Smell like street hot dog chili. Ugh, you know they be having that little bucket of chili. Y'all stupid as hell, man. San Moyo, what's happening? Chitlin smelling ass. It gotta be something they ate on the way over. They still got it on their breath. They smell like a shrimp. They smell like a large shrimp fried rice. You know everybody stop and get a large shrimp fried rice. Ugh, it stinks. It smells horrible. Terrell, what up? Hafif, what up? Welcome, y'all, to the Let Me Stretch You Out show. We here every day at this same time, man. I gotta keep reiterating that I'm gonna be here every day, so y'all gonna come back, man. Because you might think of somebody who need to be stressed out, that done stressed you out. Falami, what up? And if they stressed you out, let me stress them out. Just tell me what it is. Put it in the comments. Just tell me what it is that somebody did. Lord Crabley. Lord Crabley. Oh, that's a good one. Bag of Funyuns. Ah, that's a good one. No, it smell like the mayonnaise from Street Corn. Ugh. Ew. You can smell that a mile away. That's a good one. Yeah, onions. I like onions, but when you pile all them onions on that grill, I be like, you about to have my whole outfit smelling like a goddamn... You about to have my whole outfit smelling like a Whopper Jr. Hell no. I don't like to walk by that shit. I do not like to walk by them people cooking them hot dogs on the street with all them damn onions piled up next to it. Hell no. Hell no. Thank y'all, man. Hit that Cash App too. My Cash App right there. Shit, hit it. If you ain't got nothing to do, you about to get off here in a minute anyway. Hit that Cash App for me. Shit. Why not? Shit, we only live once. We in the COVID, baby. Thank y'all for coming to the Let Me Stretch You Out show, man. Who want to come in? Come in with me, Westside TG. Let's holla at me. Where my nigga Burpee at? Burpee probably on the radio by now. He on the radio right now. My partner Burpee, comedian Burpee, was in here, man. I would like to have brought him in. That nigga so damn funny. Yo. My way. Come on, y'all. Yes, sir. Thank y'all. Thank y'all for coming through, man. Thank y'all for coming through. Thank y'all for coming through. Thank y'all for coming through. Fried old ass. Fried with old ass. That's funny. Salad dressing. Boy, y'all funny as hell, man. I see why I follow y'all. Y'all follow me. The show tonight. Oh, okay. Don't forget the Corona Comedy Show is tonight at Ali Sadiq page at 7:30 Central Standard Time. Yeah. 7:30 my time. 7:30 Central Standard Time. 5:30 Pacific Standard Time. Ali Sadiq Corona Comedy. I'm not smoking anything, young man. What's happening, Max? You gotta be ready. You can't smoke weed every day through this damn COVID. Shit. You gonna run out. The weed places are still open, but Ali, A-L-I, Sadiq. Ali Sadiq. Ali, A-L-I-S-A-D-D-I-Q. Ali Sadiq, comedian on Instagram. Man, I don't know how you don't run out of weed, bruh. Shit. I be trying to preserve my shit. If I get some weed, I try to hang on to it. I smoke a half a little piece of weed at a time and put it out. I'm rationing my shit. I don't know what's about to happen. You gotta ration, baby. Ration. It's the COVID. Max, what up? Welcome, welcome, welcome. Falami, I know you'll never run out. You will walk from Chicago to Wisconsin before you run out of some weed now. I know you ain't gonna run out of no weed. Shout out my man Eddie Abrams. Eddie Abrams presents comedian Ali Sadiq. Yeah, that's right. Corona Comedy tonight, 7:30. There y'all go. Thank you, Vice President. Get back to work, Jessica Rabbit. I'll see you tomorrow. I'll see you tomorrow. Thank you for stopping by. Eddie Abrams, what up, man? Welcome, 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 VIP Party Pros. Welcome, Kev, to the Let Me Stress You Out show live. So you tell me who did something to you and I stress them out for it live for you right here on IG, and you'll see it posted on my page later. So whoever's watching the playback, hope you enjoyed it. Leave a comment, put some thumbs up, some hearts, some love, show some love on the page, all of that, and stay up with me. Turn the notifications on. So when you go on my page, there's three dots at the upper right-hand corner. Hit them three dots and hit turn on notifications. So that when I come on, you'll see me that I'm on and you'll know to come on. So I'm going to be doing it every day. Every day, I'm not going to get tired of it. I'm going to try to hang in there with y'all every day. D, what up? Getting warm in this joint. LA opens in July. Yes, indeed. Let's get it. Let's get it, Eddie. Say it. What up, Big Say It? Yeah, I still ain't got my stimulus lit. Ooh, I'm glad you said that, Dita. Dita, I'm glad you said that shit. I ain't got my damn Trump money yet either. I want my Trump money. I'm like, damn, when my Trump money coming. I ain't got no unemployment or nothing, said. Said, I know you got your shit. You think you got, nigga, I know you got your
I know a comedian's Big Sad in the building, man. That nigga work hard. He got
hey, what's
man.
Up, Doc?
Sad, you essential, ain't
what's
you?
What's up with it, man?
What's up, boy?
Hold up. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I hear.
What's up with it, man? You good?
Hell yeah, I'm good, man. You essential?
Huh?
You an essential worker?
Yeah, I drive Metro bus.
Oh, man, I knew you were still good.
You know, hey, boy, don't keep me a job, nigga.
Hell yeah, I knew.
Hey,
I said, thank you for my unemployment, but that nigga said probably either he get full unemployment or he's still working. That
hey, nigga, you get full unemployment though, right?
No.
You didn't get it?
I ain't got my shit yet. My shit, I filed it. This is my second time filing. I'm still waiting on my shit. That's
self-contractor. So you should be able to get it.
File it. I ain't got it yet. I'm still waiting.
Man.
Nigga, on the line, they said I had 800,000.
What? Wait. They said how much?
800,000.
That's how much you get?
No, that's how far down on the list I am.
Wow. Damn.
800,000.
God. Hey, but you back in New Orleans, all right?
Before mine.
Hey, where you at, New Orleans? Are you still in L.A.?
No, I ain't in L.A. I'm.
So when you coming back?
I don't know, shit. I don't know yet.
Man, hey, motherfuckers is motherfuckers is like doing bad, man. I'm like, God damn. Hey,
yeah, but yeah.
Nigga, I keep me a job, but
I keep me a house in the South, though.
I see.
I keep me a house in the South. Don't never get that twisted.
That's what I'm talking about. Hey, you always gotta have something in a where you know you're gonna be all
right.
Man, this is this is crazy as fuck, man. But shit getting back out to normal out here though. Motherfuckers is coming out now. It ain't like the buses are filling up like a motherfucker. So I mean, motherfuckers on my bus come to the back though. They can't come by me. They can't. Hell no, we got that shit blocked off. Then y'all gotta come to the back way and don't get 10 feet from me, nigga. That's how you gotta do it.
When they walk through that front door, you like,
I don't even open the door. I open the back door.
You just sit there with the front door closed. They be like,
right here. And then, I mean, so it's required now to wear a mask and shit, so you gotta have a mask in on everything now. Shit ain't gonna be the same no more, man.
Hell yeah, that's
ain't gonna be the same, dog. Hey, man, you about to do a comedy show today?
This is the Let Me Stress You Out show. So this is a show where I let people suggest somebody to stress them out and they like it. And they tell me about it. And I told them I'm live right now on this show.
Well, you're a genius, man.
Hey, so this is the Let Me Stress You Out show. I'm here every day, bro.
You man, when you going to release that motherfucking hour special you did, man?
It's up already. It's the link is in my bio. It didn't come out big overseas.
That motherfucker fire, bud. That motherfucker fire, homie. Nigga, that shit. Hey, nigga. You very underrated. You know that, right?
Thank you, bro.
Man, I'm telling you, homie. And you know, I don't be hating on nobody, but some of these motherfuckers are home, and then some motherfuckers are not on, I be like shaking my head, be like, damn, man. Politics like a motherfucker, man.
Keep pushing until we get it. We can't watch everybody else do what they doing. We just got to keep creating. Keep trying to get the people what they want. Say it, you breaking up. Gee, I'm going to hit you back, brother. Take care of yourself, man. Be safe. Thurston, what's happening, brother? Welcome to the Let Me Stretch Rob Show. Thank y'all for coming through for your boy. Yeah, thank you, Shelly. Welcome to the Let Me Stretch You Out Show, man. Y'all come on through in here. Come on through in here. Come on through in here. Let me stress somebody out on your behalf. Who you got? Who you got? Lurly. Who you got, Lurly? Who you got for me to stress out, Lurly? My nigga Thurston, boy, you still getting it, huh? Still doing what you do, baby boy, as you should, Thurston. I should. Hey, why we wait on somebody to, why we wait on somebody for me to stress out? Ladies and gentlemen, let me tell y'all a story. Let me tell y'all a story while we wait on somebody to type in the comments who they want me to stress out and why. Thank you for coming to the Let Me Stress You Out Show. We're here every day. 5 p.m. Central Standard Time, 3 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. Every day, Let Me Stretch You Out Show is going to go down, and it's going to get better and better, guys. Don't worry. Right now, this is just the beginning of the show, so don't trip. Just keep coming back and keep, you know, just keep posting whatever. Woo! Uber Eats and Post may stress you out. Oh, my God. Damn, man, I never drove from them niggas. I never drove from no Uber Eats or Postmates. What they be doing, Thirst? What they be doing, Thirst? Tell me what they be doing, Thirst. Tell me what they be doing. Let me stress them out for you. I could stress out a whole group of people as well. But it got to touch you, though. It got to touch you specifically. Swiss Miss, what up? Thank you for coming back. Welcome, welcome, welcome to the Let Me Stress You Out Show. I'm going to tell y'all a story. I should be stressing out my older cousin. My older cousin was trying to teach us the wrong shit when we was kids. I got an older cousin. He may be like 5 years older than me, right? When we was younger, he's not 5 years older than me. Let me see. He's probably 3 years older than me. So he's basically the same age. But back then, that's your big cousin. Big cousin used to have us at maybe like 11 years old, right? He used to have us have a beat your meat race in the house. I don't know if y'all never heard of what that is. A beat your meat race is where we would go all in the room together and we would put a porno tape on. I'm 11. He's 13 or 14. And my other cousin, he's in between both of us. He's in between both of us. I would get on the floor, he would get on the middle bunk, and the older cousin would get on the top bunk. And we would race, and we would masturbate and see who could get it done first, quickest. Whoever got it done the quickest wins. Now, why would you have us learning something like that? Why would you think that was going to be a good accomplishment to keep winning that tournament? And you got to show somebody you bust before you got to hold your hand up when you won. This was the best worst contest. A beat your meat contest? Who doing beat your meat contests when y'all was 11? Only nobody but my cousin, boy. My cousin used to have us racing to be done on masturbation. Not knowing later on when we do start having sex that this will become an issue. Yeah, I was just 11, but I'm like, when you're making a competition, I wasn't no meat beater at 11. You know what I mean? I would hold my shit and squeeze it a little bit, but I wouldn't do nothing to it because I just wasn't that, you know, experienced. But I seen it because I used to watch porn on. We used to sneak a porno in the house. We had found a porno. We had a porno tape in the ET box on the VCR tape. We took the ET movie out and put it in our drawers. And we put the porno in the box and put the box on the shelf. No. Actually, my cousin, who started the game, he would always win. He would win every time. I was like, ain't no way you did it that quick. And he'll be like, yes, I did. And he'll go like this off the side of the bed. He'll just go like this so you can see he got something on his hand. We'll be like, oh, man. Well, we'll play again later. Disgusting young men. We were terrible human beings. Delivering food. And some of these don't have an apartment code to get in the gate. You be out there with the food getting cold, thirsty. You be like, oh, man, bring your funky ass out. You know you got a cold on this damn gate. You know you got a cold on your gate. And you know, what you think, the magic cold fairy gives everybody who deliver food the cold to your apartment building? No. This is not him. No, this was on the other side of the family. No, this wasn't him. No, it could have been him, though. Damn sure it could have been him. That sounds weird. Pause. But, yeah. I ain't going to delve into that too much right now. Cause it looks like that conversation could take a dramatic turn for the worse. Thank y'all, man. Ooh! Give me an instance. Give me something that happened. Who was it? What she looked like, Thurston? Who was it? Who didn't tip? Or who did something crazy when you came to deliver the food? Who did something, Thurston? Who was it? It was a lady or was a man? He came to get his food. What he was doing? Did you not give his food? Or he tried to report you or something? What happened? Tell me, Thurston. Let me get in your business. Let me stress them out for you. I know it's one instance. I know you got one instance where something happened that was crazy. Tell it to me real quick, Thurston. We got 10 minutes left in the show, guys. Well, actually, we got 8 minutes left in the show, guys. I want y'all to just come back every day. Let me stress you out. Show. Hit that cash out, man. Shit. This is going to be a TV show. It's going to need funding. It's going to need funding in order to get better. My crown did from what's happening. Oh, I see my crown different with the blue LK. Oh, shit. I see what you're doing. We got a few more minutes left into the show, man. I want to thank y'all for coming. And, woo, without y'all, there would be no me. I don't be having a whole lot of people on here, but the people be on here is a mighty few. It's a mighty few. I got some very loyal friends that come here every day and they watch these Let Me Stress You Out and these stories that I do in between. Thank you, Jay. Every day I'm going to do a freestyle Let Me Stress You Out. That's what this show is about, the Let Me Stress You Out show, live, right here in your face on IG Live, every day at this same time. So this show started approximately 53 minutes ago. So every day come in here, bring me your burdens, bring me your problems, and let me use them to stress whoever it is who's giving you a problem out. I will stress out whoever is stressing you out. Crown different. Yes. Ooh, that nigga Thurston and Gason. He left the food on the curb. They came back today. By the time they got their shit, it was a raccoon eating that. It was a raccoon eating out of their shit by the time they got it, nigga. You told them you was outside. They saw it on the app. They saw you was 1 minute away on the app. They failed to get their funky, fat, lazy, cheesy ass up and come to the damn gate. And they know you can't get buzzed in. Ain't nobody out there. They ain't got no doorman. They just got a code to the gate. Would they think you magically knew the code? Hell no. Let that shit, let them pancakes sit on the damn curb and watch a possum be in that shit when by the time they come outside. That'll be good for their ass. The person gonna hear it because you're gonna tag them in it, Lady Hazel May. Tag them in it because this video gonna be up. I'm gonna post these shows on my timeline, on my feed. So they gonna be in the air forever. So now you're gonna not only be able to go and watch my celebrity Let Me Stress You Out roast, you're gonna also be able to get your own personal family member roasted live on the Let Me Stress You Out show. If they did something, only if they did something heinous to you, only if they did something disrespectful, despicable, nasty, just a dastardly deed. Let me do the Lord's work for you. Let me tell them what they did. You tell me what they did. Let me tell them what they did. And let me tell them what to do about it. You don't have to get a name. You can just tell me, gentlemen, tell me the scenario. I'll give them a name. They'll know it's them. They will know it's them, but they not going to know it's them because I ain't say their name. But if they know you and they do behave this way, they need to hear. Tag them from your fake page. Everybody on here got a fake page.
It's YouTube Music. Pull the app today and get started with Music Premium on up. Restrictions apply.
Thank y'all so much. Thank you so much, and definitely I appreciate that. I appreciate that support. Wordtree, a poet, a rapper, something like that. Yes, sir. I appreciate that. We just passing the money around on Cash App because I be Cash Apping other artists who doing what they doing. If they funny or if they can sing or if they can rap, I go to people page and I Cash App them. Or if they just be, you know, hey, old school, crown different. Hey, you can take the hat off in the house? Oh, you trying to see what I'm working with. You think I got the COVID hair? I do got the COVID hair under here. I got the COVID hair under here. Look, my shit just wild. My shit about to be all the way black. The tips is about to fade. It's about to be all, I'm about to have my shit still look like a little fizzle right now. It was fire. Not my shit, just a little flame right now. It's going to, the black is starting to push all the color out because I ain't been to the barbershop in 3 months. Hey. Oh, you old school. Nah, I don't believe in that shit. My shit about to be all the way back black in a minute. Thank y'all for coming to the Let Me Stress You Out show, man. The show is almost over. So if you wasn't here, if you missed it, you missed it. If you was here, you was here, and I appreciate y'all being here. If whoever missed it, watching it live was the best. It's always better if you can watch it live and you can say what you want to say throughout my rants and throughout my stress you out roast on whoever it is I'm talking about. So if you can, be here on time tomorrow. Shit, we started 58 minutes ago. And we're going to be here the same time tomorrow and the next day and the next day. I'm also doing a lot of other shit on social media and on Zoom and on all that shit too. So y'all make sure y'all keep up with it. Oh yeah, I love Savvy. That's one of my brothers. Yeah, we hang in LA a lot. Savvy funny as hell. Yes, sir. Thank y'all. Some of them gonna be great, some of them gonna be good, some of them gonna be legendary. And you gotta be here for the legendary. So you gotta be here for the good as well. And you gotta be here for the great ones to come. Yes, Come Here, Let Me Stress You Out has gone live. This is a live show every day, and it's gonna get better and better every day. I'm gonna do something to the show. Yeah, oh, I know you was late, love, but you done seen me go hard a lot of times. But love, I know you know somebody who need a good stressing out, because you be borderline giving it to them yourself. Give me one of the ones who you had to stress out before, and let me stress them out. Let me stress them out for you, love, tomorrow, 5 o'clock, 3 o'clock, love. 3 o'clock Pacific Standard Time. I love Jamie Foxx. That is a compliment. Thank you so much. I wish I had that nigga's money. Jamie Foxx's house is unbelievable. That nigga house is unbelievable. That nigga live on a ranch. That nigga don't just got a house. He got acres. He got horses. He got damn horseback riding, a pond, all kind of shit at his house. I wish. So tomorrow, love, be back on time at 3 o'clock on Instagram if you're going to be on here. 3 o'clock. Come on here, love, and tell me who it is and let me stress them out freestyle for you, for the people. Let the people see it. Let the people see what you already know. Let the new people who just